In this video, I'm going to go over some added features and diagnostic tools in Rguroo for constructing a linear regression model. In this tutorial, I'm going to be using the empty cars dataset from the R datasets package in the Rguroo repository. The categorical variables I'll be using have been properly reclassified and labeled in the variable type editor prior to performing this analysis. If you would like assistance loading this dataset, or learning more about classifying variables, please watch our video, Variable Type Editor. From the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Linear Regression. This will open the Linear Regression dialog box. From here, select the dataset Empty Cars. In our video titled Simple and Multiple Linear Regression, I showed you an example on how to implement a multiple linear regression where horsepower and the weight of the car were predictors of the miles per gallon. Now, Rguroo affords you the ability to use R syntax to transform the predictor or response variables. To do so, you would need to use this syntax in the response and formula fields. For example, we could easily do a log transformation of the response variable by typing log, parenthesis, MPG, close parenthesis. However, an appropriate transformation here would be to use an inverse transform on the response, which converts miles per gallon to gallons per mile, and then add the variable horsepower divided by weight to the main effect weight in an attempt to improve the original model. The syntax I, followed by a pair of parentheses, is an R function. According to the R documentation, this function is used to inhibit the interpretation of operators such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and exponentiation as formula operators, so they may be used as arithmetical operators. For example, in our case, each value of horsepower will be divided by its corresponding weight, and the results are treated as a single new variable in our model. Let's also click on the Include Diagnostics Table checkbox. And for the ID variable, select miles per gallon. Now let's see the results by hitting the preview icon. In this output, we can see that the residual standard error is much smaller here as compared to the untransformed model in the other video. At the very bottom of our output, we will see the case-wise estimates within the diagnostics table for the regression model we have specified. You'll also see the ID variable we added, which shows the original miles per gallon in the first column. The selected ID variable will always appear in the first column. By scrolling up to the Details button, you can request various other estimates, diagnostic plots, and diagnostic indices for our output by selecting or deselecting on the desired checkboxes. The default components in the report are already checked. Click on the Basics icon, and the Linear Regression dialog box will open up again. Now, for demonstration purposes, let's clear out our model and create a new one using the variables horsepower, which is numerical, and the categorical variable AM, which is whether a car uses an automatic or manual transmission. Now, by default, all linear models include the intercept. If you wanted to remove the intercept, you could do so by either adding a negative 1 or 0 to the terms in the formula. Hit the preview icon again, and you'll see that our regression coefficient estimates no longer provide an estimate for the intercept, and that there are two parameter estimates corresponding to the two levels, automatic and manual, for the variable AM. Moreover, by going back to the Details button, you can arrange or rearrange the order in which these graphs and tables appear in your output report by selecting and dragging each choice up and down. Let's hit the checkbox Response versus Predictor Factors, since we had a categorical variable in our last model, and then let's move this to the top. Hit the preview icon, and there's our new plot. further explore the various types of R syntax that is used for linear regression, and in particular specifying the predictor part of the model, we invite you to visit www.rdocumentation.org. If you would like more examples of simple or multiple regression using Rguroo, please reference the chapter Linear Regression from our user guidebook.